Transmission mounts are used in an automobile to secure the transmission and engine to the frame. The mount is designed with a rubber body to provide noise and vibration reduction by deforming under loading. The deformations of the mount cause cracks to grow, which eventually leads to fatigue failure. A failed transmission mount is a serious problem that causes the transmission to shake rapidly while driving, and it leads to further damage of the drivetrain. The rubber mount is subject to complex loadings. The fatigue analysis requires using critical plane analysis and rainfall counting to analyze the fatigue crack growth accurately. This is accomplished through modeling the mount in Ansys to determine the strain history, and then using the strain history and material properties in Endurica to solve for fatigue life. Here we have the transmission mount Ansys Workbench project. A static structural analysis system is used. First, the material properties are entered in engineering data. A filled natural rubber was chosen for the mount design to provide the desired loading characteristics. The filled natural rubber has been characterized with a Neo-Hookean stress-strain law. The Neo-Hookean parameters are entered in the table. The resulting hyperelastic stress-strain curves are shown in the Ansys chart. The mount geometry is modeled in Design Modeler. In Design Modeler, we see the mount contains three different parts. The rubber main body of the mount is in the center. A bent steel plate forms a bracket along the bottom of the mount where it is attached to the automobile frame. A top steel plate is used to attach to the transmission. The model, setup, solution, and results are all defined within Mechanical. Here we open Mechanical to see the model definitions. The mount geometry from Design Modeler is shown. Contact regions are defined between the rubber and steel plates so that they interact with each other in the analysis. A suitable mesh has been defined with an element size of 3 mm. The mesh uses solid 186 elements that exhibit quadratic displacement behavior and are compatible with the large deflection analysis that is used for the large deflections in the rubber under the loading. The mount has boundary conditions applied on both steel plates. The lower, bent steel plate has a fixed boundary condition applied to the three faces where it fits into the automobile frame. The top steel plate has a displacement boundary condition applied to the top face where it attaches to the transmission. The three-axis displacements of the transmission during the loading duty cycle have been measured and the displacement components entered into the tabular data table. The time displacement data for the displacement boundary condition is shown in this graph. The Ansys analysis is then ready to solve. This takes a couple minutes. Okay, now that the solution is finished, we can load the strain history results. Here's an animation of the mount strain history. The maximum strain during the loading history is 55%. Now we are ready to begin the fatigue analysis. The loading history from Ansys is exported into Endurica CL as part of the input for the fatigue life calculations. The Endurica toolbar for Ansys makes exporting to Endurica easy. On the Endurica toolbar, click on the Export HFI icon to open the Endurica export interface. On the Source tab, the element set to analyze is picked. In this case, the element set rubber is picked that contains all the rubber elements in the model. The result sets allows the analysis steps to be selected that will be used in the fatigue analysis. In this case, the entire result set is picked. The HFI output file is then selected as the file to write the exported strain history to. This file is used by Endurica as the input to the fatigue analysis. The HFI file is a text file, which is open here. The HFI file contains output requests and material properties. The Ansys strain history will be appended to the end of this file. In the History tab, the 3D model bulk history type is selected, and then the Export button is clicked to write the history type to the HFI file. In the Field tab, the source is selected, and then the Export button clicked to write the strain history results from ANSYS to the Endurica HFI input file. The HFI file can be reloaded to view the ANSYS exports. The HFI file now contains the history exports from ANSYS and is ready to be submitted for the fatigue analysis. The analysis is submitted by clicking on the Run Job icon on the Endurica toolbar in ANSYS. The HFI file is selected and the Run button is clicked to start the analysis. It takes a few minutes to run the fatigue analysis. Let's fast forward to the completion of the analysis. Now that the analysis is complete, the results are viewable in ANSYS by clicking the Import Life icon. The details are filled out to include the HFO file, the output, and the output frequency before evaluating the results. Now the fatigue life is viewable on the model. The results are best viewed on a logarithmic scale using the high fidelity option and with a reverse rainbow color scheme so that the minimum life is shown in red. The fatigue life calculated here is 56 million cycles and is shown in the corner here with the minimum icon. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Endurica channel on YouTube by clicking the subscribe button below, and if you liked our video, be sure to give us a thumbs up and share the video.